Easter. Thank you all for coming this morning to our garden service. When you plan something like this 2 months in advance in April in Minnesota, you have no idea what you're going to get. And while it could be, I see from coats and scarves a little bit warmer, it could not be a whole lot more beautiful out here. So we're grateful that you're here. Hope you will stay following for warm cinnamon rolls and warm coffee, and it'll all be good. But please join me now as we call ourselves to this garden worship service. Out of the darkness of grief and despair comes a message of hope. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
We run to the tomb to see for ourselves, and it is true. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
We hear a voice call our name, and we know our risen Lord is with us now and always. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Thanks be to God.
Let's join together in our opening prayer.
O God of all our days, we come this morning with eager anticipation. We seek to know you, to see you, to touch you. Open our hearts that we might experience you anew. Open our lives that we may be faithful witnesses to your resurrection. May we, with shouts of joy, proclaim your steadfast, liberating love to all people everywhere.
Thank you.
Our gospel reading this morning is the ancient and familiar story of the resurrection as it comes to us from the gospel according to John. Listen to what the Holy Spirit is saying to the community of faith this day. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came following him and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying in a place by itself. Then the other disciple who reached the tomb first also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand, the scripture that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father, but go to my brothers and say to them, 'I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God.'" Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and she told them that he had said these things to her. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So friends, we have a skit for you for this morning. And this skit I came up with on Friday afternoon and then began looking for people to be in it. So we haven't had a chance to practice it. I am trusting that the Spirit has brought us together this morning and will make this all happen. So here we sit in the garden, and perhaps we're eavesdropping on what was going on in that garden.
Recipe for a resurrection.
Take a hole in a hill.
A tomb, if you like.
That's right, a tomb.
With a large stone nearby.
Make that a very large stone.
Looking suspiciously like it had just been rolled away.
Which in fact was the case.
Go on.
Upon which sits an angel.
Very nice, isn't he?
She?
And then? A party of melancholic followers of the late,
or so it seems,
Jesus of Nazareth.
Making helpful comments like,
"I wonder who'll roll away the stone from the tomb for us." She obviously hadn't been listening to the drama.
The angel was aware of this and said,
"Don't be alarmed. You're looking for Jesus who was crucified, right? Well, you're looking in the wrong place. Tombs are for dead people. And Jesus, well, he's not dead. He's risen. See for yourself, he's not here. But there's a message for the disciples. He's going ahead of you to Galilee. You'll meet him there, just like he told you in Mark 14:28, okay?
It wasn't really okay.
This was all a bit much for the women.
They fled the tomb and promptly said
nothing
to anyone.
Because they were afraid.
Sound familiar?
We move on.
Enter a bunch of disciples for later reference.
Note their downcast nature and hopeless acting. Hopeless appearance.
Thanks very much, very much.
They're mourning the death of their Lord and friend Jesus.
Meantime, back in the garden.
What's the matter?
They have taken my Lord away and I don't know where they've put him. Sir, if you have taken him, please tell me where he is.
Mary.
Teacher!
Hold on a moment. Go inside and give my message to the disciples that I am returning to our Father. Go.
So that's what she did.
Hey, James, Peter, Andrew.
What is it?
Yeah, not next time, Mary. You have scared the life out of me.
Is it something important? We're busy being miserable.
I've seen Jesus. He's alive. He's risen. He has.
Mary, that's not funny.
It's not meant to be funny. It's wonderful.
Are you feeling all right?
Not too long out in the sun.
Come on, fellas. I'm telling you, Jesus is alive.
Now listen, Mary. We all know he was very dear to you.
He still is. He's alive.
Let me finish. And dear to us. But you must start to face the facts. You yourself saw him die.
And I've seen him this morning risen.
Come on, Mary. You can't expect me to believe that.
Yeah, that's overdoing it a bit. What do you mean, saw him?
I saw him, okay?
But of course it wasn't okay.
No. It's not okay.
See?
He even gave me a message for you.
This is getting freaky.
Unless I see the nail marks in his hands and put my hand in his side, I will not believe it.
No prizes for guessing who he is.
Look, Mary, we all saw him die, and you're the only one who's seen him risen, so you say.
But at that moment,
we've seen the Lord! We've seen the Lord!
Oh, here we go.
Perfect timing. Direct from the road to Emmaus, Cleopas and company.
Hold on, there must be some logical explanation for this.
There is! Jesus is risen!
Not again. Unless I see the nail marks in his hand and put my hand on his side, I will not believe.
Thank you, Thomas.
Where did you see him?
We were on the way to our home, Emmaus, when he started to walk along with us. Only we didn't know it was him until later when he broke the bread at our house. We'd asked him to stay the night with us. But he just vanished. So we thought we'd better tell you. Jesus is risen!
I can't believe it. We all saw him die.
Unless I see the...
Thank you, Thomas!
Oh.
And there we have a recipe for a dead faith.
Take a hard-hearted person. Who, us?
Who hasn't met the risen Jesus. No, of course not.
And doesn't believe those who have.
And don't want to, anyway.
Put them in a life with no belief.
A tomb, if you like.
Like a tomb, certainly.
And roll a stone carefully over the entrance.
Well, they've made up their minds, haven't they?
And leave them.
They die, of course.
Of course.
And some do.
But Jesus is into resurrection.
Peace be with you. Hello, my friends. Didn't you believe? Didn't I tell you that I'd risen from the dead? Thomas, see my hands? Put your hand onto my side, Thomas. Stop doubting. Believe.
My Lord, my God.
You believe me because you have seen me. Happy are those who have not seen me but believe anyways. Go into all the world and preach the good news to all creation.
So they went.
And they preached.
They baptized.
They healed.
They taught.
They were persecuted.
Some were martyred.
They were obedient.
They believed.
The question, friends, is, do you?
In the garden.
us bow together in prayer. Risen Christ Jesus, on this Easter morning, we welcome you into our lives. We welcome your resurrection, for it is life-changing, life-giving, and life-sustaining. We welcome the hope it brings to our world. We welcome the joy it brings to our darkness. We welcome the peace it holds for our souls. We welcome the empty tomb, for we know that it means you are on the loose and present in our lives and working in our world. Lord, may your resurrection give life to those who feel lifeless, those who are just going through the motions, and those who have suffered losses of any kind. Lord, may your resurrection give hope to those who are mired in despair, whose lives are filled with sadness or tears, and who do not know how to feel joy. Lord, may you be on the loose in this world as the risen one. Great God of victory, the very earth celebrates your triumph as fresh green life bursts forth from beneath piles of snow and cold. We, like those first green blades of spring, reach toward the radiance of the rising sun. Through him, we are truly free. Because he is risen, sin and death have no power to hold us in the grave. Allow us now, we pray, to rise to the challenges of our daily lives with the energy of people who have been given a new lease on life, a fresh start with all good things now possible again. Awaken us to the delights we overlook in our routine haste and worry. Show us uncontrived beauty in unexpected and ordinary places. Show us mirth in the midst of serious business. Show us energy for change in the course of our regular rut. Show us the solid ground that exists in this quaking and breaking world. Show us peace as we hear drumbeats of war all over our world. Gracious Holy Spirit, help us to leave behind, like the empty grave cloth, all the cowering and craving in which this world has schooled us so well. Lead us forth, we pray, full of courage into this new day, into this new season of growth and grace, into this time of victory over temptation and torment from the evils whose power over us is now ended. Guide us in resurrection truth. Fill us with resurrection peace, for we ask it all in the name of the risen Christ, who, when he gave his disciples words to pray, taught them, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you. kitchen is, the cinnamon rolls aren't quite ready. Let's bless ourselves together with this responsive benediction. With hope reborn, we go out to proclaim good news. The brightness of this day is meant to be shared.
We have seen the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the one we have been seeking.
Run to tell others that Christ is alive. Spread the message through the land.
Beyond the cross is the message of peace. Beyond death is the promise of new life.
God is our strength and our might. God answers our prayers and equips us for living.
We have been raised with Christ to fuller life. May God's reign be evident in us.